they're sure to come and go. They meet me at a time when I'm calm and doing fine. But the captain of my soul, he's always on board. He rocks me in his arms while riding through the storm.
Good morning, and welcome to our morning virtual worship service. We would like to thank Brother McFall for our Sunday school lesson on last week. Today, we will begin with a word from our pastor, Sunday school lesson with Deacon Baker, followed by church announcements.
Good morning. Thank you once again for allowing us into your residence on this Sunday morning. To God be the glory for the safekeeping and the sparing of our lives. Let us continue to pray, and this is a time when we need to continue to uplift this country and countries around the globe. This morning, notice with us from the book of Mark, chapter number 6, and there we're going to begin at the 45th verse. Reading is rather lengthy this morning, so follow along with me. I'll be reading from the New International Version. Immediately Jesus made his disciples get into the boat and go on ahead of him to Bethsaida while he dismissed the crowd. After leaving them, he went up on a mountainside to pray. Later that night, the boat was in the middle of the lake and he was alone on land. He saw the disciples straining at the oars. King James says that they had trouble rowing. They were straining at the oars because the wind was against them. King James says contrary. Shortly before the dawn, he went out to them walking on the lake. He was about to pass by them. But when they saw him walking on the lake, they thought he was a ghost. They cried out because they all saw him and were terrified. Immediately he spoke to them saying, "Take courage, it is I, don't be afraid." Amen. That's in your Bible, in whatever version you might be reading from. Say amen to yourself. This morning, there are times in our lives when it seems like the Lord is not present. There are times when it seems like we can't get a prayer through, or that our prayers are taking too long to be answered. So I stopped by this morning to encourage you with the thought, never count God out. Never count God out. The frightened disciples in their storm-driven boat represent the circumstances by which believers are often tried. Disappointment, sickness, and loss of loved ones. Being a believer does not exempt us from storms. This is nothing strange that is happening. While the disciples were battling their storm, I'm sure that the question came up, where is Jesus? They were not forgotten. Jesus was watching. And he sees the storms that we are going through. God has not forsaken us. We need not feel that God has forsaken us or has stopped loving us. God allows these trials so that Christ may draw near. As we look to him in faith, keep your eyes on Jesus and your mind on things eternal. This will not allow you to praise God in everything and give thanks, because your eternal mindset, you will know that nothing will separate you from the love of Jesus. When we are distracted, it does not allow us to praise God in everything and give thanks. But when we have an eternal mindset, we will know that nothing will separate us from the love of God. Persecution cannot separate us. Trials and tribulations cannot separate us. Those who seek to kill us and death cannot separate us from the love of Jesus. One reason why God has permitted this world to be in an uncomfortable place to live in and to live with disease and sickness and earthquakes and floods and fires and global pandemics and bereavement. The reason why God allows it is so that people may turn to him in their distress, so that he might bless them. And so we can see how God uses even the evil that Satan causes to work so that it might cause us to turn to him. Jesus says, "Lo, I am with you." But there are times when he's not recognized. To recognize him, we must expect him. He has promised to be there. When you pass through the waters, he said, I will be with you. And he who died for our sins will not fail us. In our darkest hours, Jesus knows who needs him. The fear of the disciple parallels our lives at times. Though we may have never been in a ship during a storm on the Sea of Galilee, we all get into storms from time to time. When we do, we can count on Jesus to come to our rescue as he did those 12 men in the boat. Just as the fierce winds and waves of the storm threaten the peace and the well-being of his disciples, so it is that the storm of COVID-19 is threatening our peace and our well-being. Never forget that this storm that we are in today, or the one we face tomorrow, did not come to stay, but they all came to pass. The psalmist says, weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. And just like joy comes in the morning, when his disciples were in the midst of the lake and the storm came out of nowhere, Jesus comes to the rescue. Don't count him out. You may not feel his presence. It may seem like he's not there, but don't count him out. The Bible says immediately, Jesus made his disciples, after feeding the 5,000, get in the boat and go ahead of him to Bethsaida while he dismissed the crowd. I tell you this morning that you may be doing what God said and still find yourself in a storm. After leaving them, He went up to the mountainside to pray. And later that night, the boat was in the middle of the lake, and Jesus was on land all by himself. He saw the disciples straining to row the boat, and because they were rowing right into the midst of the wind, because the wind was against them. And shortly before dawn, in the darkest hour of the night, he came walking on the lake. And the Bible says he was about to pass them by. But when they saw him walking, they thought he was a ghost. They didn't recognize him. Quite often in our lives, Jesus is doing some things. He's working in our life, and we don't recognize him. But they cried out because they saw him, and they were terrified. Immediately he spoke to them and said, "Take courage. It is I. Don't be afraid." Then he climbed into the boat with them, and the wind died down. And they were amazed at the supernatural power of Jesus. Jesus came to his disciples during the darkest part of the night. And when the disciples were exhausted, miserable, and tired, and wondering if they were going to survive or not, only then did the Lord come. We should also be reminded that Jesus comes to us in ways we do not expect. When the disciples were tossed about in the boat, there was little doubt that some of them thought, if only Jesus were with us, he would find some way of seeing us through. But when he came in the way that he did, in the way that they did not expect, instead of welcoming his appearance, they became terrified. They were frightened. And so are we when we cannot recognize Jesus in our situations. One thing this morning is certain is that the Lord's way is full of surprises. Christ constantly comes to us in ways that we don't anticipate. You may know the Lord, but you will never know him seriously until he has come to you in the middle of one of your storms of life. In the lives of the disciples, the absence or the presence of faith was revealed in the hardships of life. And my brothers and my sisters, this morning, hardships will test our faith every time. Not sometime, but every time. So it is with us as well. It is the storms of life that our faith is revealed. It is in the crisis of life that reveals our faith. It is such a time that we face a threefold challenge. We are challenged to worry, to work, or to trust. And my brothers and my sisters, when difficulties come, we can choose to worry. But we all know deep down that worry changes nothing. And when we are faced with adversity, while we can try harder and harder until we see that there's nothing more that we can do, and we are forced to conclude that it's absolutely out of control. Or we can call to the Lord and ask for his help. While Peter invites us in 1 Peter 5 and number 7 to let him have our worries, to cast all of our cares upon him, because he's always thinking about us and watching everything that concerns us. Jesus longs for us to be able to trust him. The only one that can take us through a storm. I'm not talking about going around the throne. I'm not talking about going over the storm. But Jesus, can take us through the storm. Well, people say that God doesn't care about me. He doesn't care that I'm going through such a time as this. He doesn't care, but I want you to understand this morning that that's not true. Well, storms come as a part of every life. Yes, the whole point of the story of the parable is that storms happen. Yes, they do. The truth is that nobody gets through life without experiencing a storm. Yes, in fact, most lives contain more than one storm. Yes, that threatens our sense of well-being. Yes, I stopped by this morning to tell you that storms, come in many forms. Yes, the storm of sickness, sudden sickness. Yes, prolonged sickness. Yes, the storm, of bereavement. Yes, the death of somebody we love. The storm, of rejection, separation, and divorce. Well, the storm, of adversity and affliction. Yes, storms come, in all shapes and sizes. Yes, the storm, of trouble and trial. Yes, the storm of danger and distress. The storm, of family problems. Yes, but I'm glad this morning, in the midst of the storm. Now, Jesus, comes walking. Yes, and he says, it is I. It is I. Well, is all that you need in your storm. Yes, Mark says immediately he spoke to them. Yes, and he said, take courage. Well, it is I. And that's all we need to know in our storm. Yes, it is I. It is I, that is with you. Yes, it is I. Yes, that will help you through the storm. Yes, then he climbed into the boat with them. Yes, I want you to understand this morning. Whatever storm you're in, you're not alone. Yes, God will climb into your situation. Yes, right where your storm is. He will never leave you, and he'll never forsake you. Yes, never count God out. Yes, you may think he's absent and that he doesn't care. Yeah, but the truth is he'll never leave you. He's Emmanuel, God with us. He's always by our side. Never count God out. Yeah, no matter what you face in life, he's always available. When you call his name this morning in your storm, and he will let you know that it is I who will see you through. If you call him, he'll be there when you need him. Call him this morning. No matter who you are, where you live, or where you've been, or what you've done, you can be saved this morning if you call him. Romans 10 and 13 reminds us that whosoever, God has no respect of person. God is not a racist. So whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. I don't care how dark it gets. I don't care how rough the wind gets. I don't care how terrible your storm might be, don't ever count God out. When you need him the most, you find out that he's walking right there beside you. He won't carry you over your thorn. He won't carry you under your storm. He will not carry you around your storm. But God is there to carry you through your storm. Whatever you do, brothers and sisters, don't count God out. You be blessed, you be encouraged. Continue to pray. If there ever was a time that we needed to pray, the time is now. Don't count God out. Call him, and he'll be there. He knows what you're going through. Just call him, and he'll be there. Until the next time, my brothers and my sisters, see you.
Good morning, second honor and friends. Our science you topic this morning, wisdom, the way, truth, and light. John, the 14th chapter, 1st through the 14th verse. Key verse. Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Jesus' discussion with disciples in anticipation of his death and recalled the promised gift of the Holy Spirit. As he attempts to prepare them for the upcoming events, which is his death, resurrection, and ascension, he instructs them to continue his work and comfort them with the assurance that they will eventually be united with him. In John 14:1, he tells them to let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, also believe in me. Disciples have been greatly distressed at what Jesus had said about leaving them. Perhaps they had indicated their distress to him in some manner by their facial expression. And he proceeded new to minister to them such consolation as the circumstance made proper. The discussion in which chapter took place while they were sitting at the table partaking of the Lord's Supper. They had believed in him, but they were so confused over the prospect of his death and departure that they stumbled. He bid them to see in him as they believe in God, to trust him if they did not comprehend, to walk by faith rather by sight through the darkness of that hour, to understand these words. The confusion, sorrow, and despair of his disciple over his death must not be forgotten. Though Jesus had often told them of his approaching death and resurrection, yet it seemed they did not understand him, nor did they fully comprehend him until after his resurrection. Disciples did not understand what Jesus was telling them when he said to them, if you have known me, you should have known my Father. And Philip said, we have seen and adored thee, and our happiness will be complete if thou showest the Father. He answered Philip by telling him that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me. On account of the works of the miracles themselves, and Jesus' own testimony was sufficient to convince them. All the many miracles which he had performed in healing the sick, raising the dead, and giving sight to the blind. The miracle which I have wrought could not have been wrought but by the omnipotence of God. But that omnipotence can work greater. And those who believe on my name shall, through my almighty power, be able to work greater miracles than that which I had originally wrought. And possibly might seduce the people by false miracles. But he could not make his power and cunning pass on to all those who were seduced by him. But I will give you this proof of divinity of my mission and the truth of my doctrine. I shall receive the Holy Spirit and send down his abundant influence into the heart of those who believe. In my closing, Jesus said, and Whatsoever you shall ask in my name, that will I do. God will glorify himself through Christ by answering prayer just made. Thank you, and God bless you, and have a good day.
Join us on Tuesday for Bible study. We will be streaming all services on our YouTube channel, the church's website, as well as on Facebook. A link will also be provided each week. Also, join us on the prayer line at 7 p.m. on Wednesdays. Dial 1-605-313-5086. The access code is 796275#.
Harvest Day contributions, tithes and offerings, as well as all building fund donations, can be contributed through the GiveLify app in person from 12:30 p.m. to 4:30 p.m. or by mail.